Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to another episode of Cricket with Zidane. And another racking thriller has come between Islamabad and Ari Multan Sultan. A low scoring thriller that was again. But I mean, it was so good that I better say it is one of the best PSL matches I've ever seen. First of all, of course, Islamabad United, it's a really experienced side. And you know, it always happens in the first that Islamabad is known for defending low totals. It has always defended low totals. If you see how it has defended it, but then failed to do it in the end was so dramatic, a dramatic change. Islamabad United ended for 125. So what happened? Now if you see, I think the batting only depended on Luke Ronke, because Luke Ronke, he was playing really good, but nobody could carry on the partnership with them. And maybe the batting wasn't carried on. Since the wicket of Rizwan Hussain, it was pretty much down for them. They weren't then keeping up the pace and not any rhythm which was coming. There was no tone in there, okay? I mean, that pretty much set the tone when Muhammad Irfan got it. The momentum of the wickets was still going, because that rhythm of wickets, one wicket, two wickets, then what was happening? That there was a total collapse for Islamabad. I think, yeah, if you see, this was a pitch good for the batsman. I mean, a pitch good for the batsman. It would go in the favor of the batsman. No due, totally flat pitch. That meant that, of course, Islamabad would get a lot of runs on the board. And everybody was surprised by the time Shuaib Malik elected to bat. Now, if you see, I think, Ali Shafiq got the momentum of the wickets, and Shahid Afridi. Ali Shafiq, the emerging player, 2 for 11 in 4 overs. Lovely. That was for Islamabad United. Then after that, we have Shahid Afridi. Boom, boom. He's not going to leave it out. He also did it with 2 for 18 in 4 overs. So I think that was got them. And when they were, 96 for 7. That was what made them to go to 96 for 7. And I mean, then after that, when Sam Patel and Faiz Ashraf came, that was when they both scored 20 runs respectively. And then after that, that set the tone, which got them to 125. But I don't think so 125 was a defendable target. Somebody should have carried the partnership with Luke Ronke. The next batsman became Cameron Delport, should have carried the partnership, played it a little bit slow for the next overs, and then after that, go ahead, because there were so many overs still remaining, and it was the fourth over where Rizwan Hussain's wicket went. So I think they should have played slow, and then I think after that, after the seventh or eighth over, they should have started get it, because they were building confidence at that time. They didn't build the confidence. They went aerial at just that same time, and when you go aerial, it's very risky after losing one wicket. And of course the rhythm of wickets was a lot, and then it was all history when he just lifted it up. He was just trying to lift it up over his shoulder, got a really shot. Muhammad Irfan is a tall man, he would catch it without anything. So now, good bowling done by Multan. But what did Islamabad do when it was chasing? Okay, now what was happening at, if I want to see from Multan perspective, 125 is gonna be really easy, since it was a pitch where it was so good for the batsman. But what happened? Waqas Maqsood. Now see, Waqas Maqsood is just a youngster who has come and playing his second match in the PSL. First match, AB de Villiers wicket was his first wicket ever in the PSL. So now the second wicket, his second wicket. So the first wicket when he got Jonathan Charles was a really good one. If you see, Waqas Maqsood pitched it wide outside, and then that's when Jonathan Charles got. And now if you see, Jonathan Charles is such a good batsman. He's a big hitter. We have seen him play in the BPL. Oh my, that was so good. Innings was good. ATS BPL 2017. Then after that, in numerous leagues. But we haven't seen him perform in the PSL today. The replacement player picked up from West Indies couldn't perform. That was when Islamabad got the momentum which Multan got, Yeah, that is where they got it. And then, sure enough, the second wicket went to Roy Evans. If you see, Islamabad had the game in control. Then after that, they just had to build pressure. When it was 48 for 3 in 10 overs, then they just had to build pressure, give Yorkers wide, just a little bit wide, which can give catches. This pressure which they could build, not to give loose balls, not to keep the loose field, a really close field, tight field, I mean, yeah, tight field, right? And then they gave, I mean, very, they should have given these balls to keep it very tight, especially such a low target. So, I mean, yeah, that's what they did, but I don't think so. Sami Zova did went good because, I mean, he was hit a lot because then after that there were 68 in 12 overs. I mean, that wasn't good, but Sami just did the right thing. He gave the wild ball, the tight ball, right? That's why, I mean, yeah, they got some way, he almost got some wickets, okay? 2 wickets were almost down. And now, again, I think this was the mistake made by Islamabad, run out chances Islamabad couldn't get. That is the problem, and I don't think so. The fielding was, I mean, any bad at all. They did excellent fielding. And yeah, till the 18th, 17th over, I think they played really good. I think I salute them. Yeah, that's good. That was really good. I think the Islamabadians, they made one really bad mistake. I think this is the mistake they made. They kept it loose in the last overs. Maybe because Samit Patel was not available or Shadab Khan. Shadab Khan did a good spell. Samit Patel also set the tone. But then after that, nothing could happen. Then when Russell's wicket was gone, that was very good. That was where the momentum was gone. And that was the momentum Multan Sultans was suppressed. Now, how to do it? How they had to do it? Actually, after Fahim Ashraf's over, I think that was where Multan Sultans got the grasp. Multan Sultans, I mean, when Fahim Ashraf slipped and fell and then went for 4, that is where I think it was down. And then again, Waqas Maqsood, his last over, he got hit for 2 sixes. That is, I think, where they lost the game. Where they lost the game, from my point of view, I think, is where, I mean, Fahim Ashraf slipped and fell down. That is, I think, and I think, yeah, he's been having trouble with the pitches lately because he did it again against Lahore. He slipped and fell, but I mean, that didn't go again for a wide. But if you see, when you're giving 125 runs, defending it, you should never, ever, ever, ever. And when Afridi is there, you should never, ever, ever give a wide ball to him, a really wide ball. Just if you give him in the give him a Yorker or something like that. That is my, you know, you can give any run. But if you give Afridi some width, he's gonna kill you. He's gonna kill everybody who gives width to him. He's gonna kill the ball. Yeah, and that's what Fahim Ashraf, Waqas Maqsood did. He gave width to Afridi. And you know, Afridi has been also playing these shots. He always hits it towards cover and then it's out. 6 is towards the off, right? And when you give width to Afridi on the off, he's gonna kill you, literally. Because he hits it towards the off, a 6. And then that's when it goes. But then after that, on the second ball, Afridi, I mean, got it straight. You know, the pull shot, and then it went straight. I mean, it didn't, I mean, they go like, I mean, it went straight as a bullet. That is where I think they lost the game. I don't think the Waqas Maqsood should have given width to Afridi. That was the problem, I think. I think they should have given him on the leg side, a bit close. Or he should have given him a Yorker. But I don't think so. That width thing was any good because, but I don't, yeah, maybe, yeah, some bowlers didn't do a good job. Waqas Maqsood didn't do a good job in particular because, I mean, he couldn't get the ball to swing. Otherwise, first of all, he got, I mean, all the Islamabad bowlers except Shadab, I mean, couldn't get the ball to swing or, I mean, get some spice on the ball and get the momentum which the Multan Sultans bowlers did. So I think this was a very good match. 18.4 overs, not out, in Multan Sultans won the match. Such a good thriller. Had Afridi didn't hit sixes, had he not given width to Afridi, I think the Islamabadians would have got it for them. So this is all for today. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to see more videos, go to my website sinam.com or you like my Facebook page. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the ding button, and then you'll notify for more videos. I'll be waiting for your feedback. Assalamualaikum.